Hello guys, welcome to my channel. I am Tanya.
2,000 years later.
Like a single, she want a boyfriend. She's a bad girl, she got bad friends. She got one life, she's living it up. She don't give a fuck. Like a single, she want a boyfriend. She's a bad girl, she got bad friends. She got one life, she's living it up. She don't give a fuck.
So today I'm gonna show you how to clean your facial hairs this quarantine, and we'll also share myths about shaving your facial hairs and using razor on hands and legs. So we will start with upper lips, and for it we need to have this thread. Take about this much. Open the loop and twist it like this. Now keep your thumb here and use this motion. So now it's done, it's clear. Now coming to your eyebrows, and for that we need four hands, one here and two for holding the thread, which is not possible. So for that we will take this little weapon, open it like this, and it has a blade over here. I bought this from Miniso. This thing is amazing. You should also give it a try. And to use it, you just have to put your fingers here and stretch this part. Use light hands to remove your hairs. For the hairs of this part, which grows upwards, you need a little scissor and cut the extra hairs. And that's done. Can you see the difference? I'll do this part and I'll be back. So I'm done with the second eyebrow, and I use my eyebrow palette to fill in the areas where I have less growth, and it's done. If you have hairs on your forehead and chin, you can use this thread to pull out that hairs. But for this part, you cannot use this thread because it can be really painful. So for it, you can use the razor. But still, there are many myths using razor on your face, hands and legs, which is not true. Do not believe on anything, because majority of people believing it to be true. You have your own mind. God has given you that, so use it. People believe that shaving your hairs with a razor will actually make your hairs thick and it will increase your hair growth, which is not true. But shaving makes your hair end blunt. That's why it feels that they are thicker than before, but actually it is not. When you use wax on your skin, it pulls out your hairs from the roots, and when the new growth comes, it comes out pointed, which gives us the feeling that we have lesser hairs. And when you shave it, the razor cuts out your hairs from the skin surface, and when the new growth comes, the blunt end pops out first, which gives us the feeling that we have darker and thicker hair. Coming to the second myth, people also believe that your skin will turn darker when you shave your hairs, but again it is not true. The only reason of that darker skin is because of the blunt end. I personally go out for waxing just because it delays my next hair growth for about 10 to 15 days, but it is painful. On the other hand, shaving your hairs is not painful at all, but the hair growth comes again in just 2 to 3 days. Now the third thing is ingrown hairs, and to avoid that, you need to exfoliate your skin after shaving using a mild scrub. Problem solved. Hair growth is totally genetic. If your hair growth is faster, then you can shave it every day or every alternate day. Coming to the fourth point, people believe that their skin will become itchy after shaving, and it is true. The only solution to this problem is to use moisturizer. Moisturizer is the only thing that can give relief to your itchy skin, and you can use any moisturizer to moisturize your skin after shaving and exfoliate. Don't forget to exfoliate, and moisturizing both are the process for a good smooth skin. Some people also face the problems of bumps and blister on their skin after shaving, but it is totally depend on your skin and its sensitivity. If you follow the whole regime of moisturizing, exfoliating and everything that I told you, then you will not face such problems. And make sure to Shave against your hair direction and not towards the hair direction, because that's the easiest way to get the closest shave. Don't be very harsh to your skin. Use the lightest hand you can to avoid any cuts or blister or bumps, and make sure to be very gentle to your skin. If you have sensitive skin, then you can use shaving gel that contains aloe vera in it, and make sure that your razor is sharp enough that you can remove your hairs in just one or two swipes. If you need to run your razor again and again on your skin, it means that your blade has gone blunt and you need to buy a new razor. If you have more hairs on your skin and your skin is really sensitive, then you can go for laser treatment. Next myth is that when you shave, your skin can get dry and flaky, but again, it is not true. When you shave, you actually get rid of dead skin cells and it leaves your skin very soft and smooth, but you still need to moisturize it really well to get rid of any flaky, dry or itchy skin. Always use good quality razor. Do not use the razor that men use or the razors which has single blades. I use this razor from Miniso. This is the best razor that girls can use. It has three blades and a soft strip over here, and it twists like this so that you cannot get any cut at this area, knee area or your ankle area. It also gives you a nicer and closer shave. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoy watching my video. Stay home, stay safe, use sanitizer, wash your hands, wear a mask when you are going out, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to be a part of my family and hit the bell icon so that you can get notification when I upload a new video. Bye bye.